For just about everyone, young and old alike, this is the time of year when there's a lot to look forward to. But for two teams in particular, it's been a week with decidedly different emotions.
That's not bad, though.
Get out of here with that.
Concern on one side.
Hit his head right on that post.
Yeah, that's going to be it for Corey Crawford.
Hope on the other.
We're looking forward to having those guys back. Hopefully they're playing by the Winter Classic.
Now, as the build-up to the game, like no other, reaches its final stages.
One shift at a time.
Welcome. We're getting better.
This is still our game.
Yeah, we're all right. Just relax.
Each are forced to approach their mutual moment from seemingly opposite directions on the road to the NHL Winter Classic.
I love the whole elf on the shelf thing and figured he could be my little guy to sit up here and look over the place. So he's a pretty cool looking dude, so I think he works.
I remember I got traded here just thinking of the possibilities of playing with some of these guys and more of the big stages, and it's what you dream about, really.
After missing much of the early part of the season with an injury, Chicago Blackhawks defenseman Connor Murphy has only recently returned to the lineup, just in time, in fact, to cross off an item from his bucket list.
I've never played in a structured game outside, definitely a lot as a kid. In Columbus, my close buddy who's on the Bruins, Sean Crowley, and his dad would make an outdoor rink in their backyard in Notre Dame. I feel like it'll be a good stage for us to prove that we're a better team than where our record is and prove that we're better than what we've shown to start the year. So I think guys will be looking forward to that.
Do we have any reds, guys?
For Murphy and the Hawks, there's still plenty of hockey to be played prior to the Winter Classic. Unfortunately for coach Jeremy Culleton, Chicago will have to play them without Corey Crawford, the team's number one goaltender. He suffered a concussion in the Hawks' previous game, a 7-3 loss to the San Jose Sharks.
Tomorrow just makes me look bad. He knows I'm hitting him right in the pad.
For now, Cam Ward will be in the net.
Wow.
And the Stanley Cup winning veteran appears up for the challenge.
The one-man PK.
You know, I've been doing this for quite a while now, and a lot of it is, opportunities, and I think you want to take advantage of those opportunities when given, and this is no different in year 14, and my old saying is the more fun you have, the better you do. I don't want to overthink it, just go out there and do my thing and have some fun.
Ralph, relax.
Dylan Strome and Alex DeBrincat can't seem to get enough hockey. Whether it's on their couch or actually playing for the Chicago Blackhawks, as both 21-year-olds do. A somewhat recent and fortunate occurrence for Strome.
You know, when I got the call from the general manager in Arizona that I was being traded, you know, immediately called Alex. Because we lived together for our third and fourth year in junior, and just made it so much easier just coming to play with your best friend, so it's pretty cool.
When he came in, chemistry was there right away. Even from the first practice, you know, you could see it, and it's been a lot of fun for me to have him here. Now it's time to take Ralph out on a walk. Ready, bud?
Only 3 years ago, Strome was the third overall pick in the draft. And as the Blackhawks inject younger players into the lineup, Chicago is hopeful this is the place where his career will mature.
I want to body check you so bad right now.
Just quick elbow.
He and Nilsi take one end. Bergie go with the whites down here.
It's a couple of days after the Bruins' 4-0 win over Montreal. And there's even more good news at practice. Patrice Bergeron and Zdeno Chara are back, a sign they're both close to rejoining a team that's already playing quality hockey.
Good gaps the other night, Chuck. I think the rest comes easy for you when you're on time. Good gaps. You're real good. Keep it up.
Appreciate it.
The win on the road, however, did come with a price. one the defenseman Stephen Kampfer had to accept, however grudgingly.
So Sean broke his nose, gave him a lot of because he had to put the full face mask on, and I take a puck to the mouth and I got to put one on.
You made fun of me.
I deserved it.
100% I deserved it. Yeah, 100%. Touche. I would take your nose over my lip, though.
Was it going through your head that, like, maybe I shouldn't have said something to Curls the other day? And
at least 10 times. Was like, this is karma for making fun of you.
Don't want to happen again, bud.
For years, John Grzelcyk was on the crew responsible for changing the floor of the TD Garden from basketball to hockey and back again. These days, he still helps out in the very building his son Matt now calls his professional home as a second-year defenseman for the hometown team.
Hey, what's up, Matt?
What's up? You hungry?
A little bit. Why? Where are we going? Are we going somewhere?
Going to Monica's.
All right.
North End.
Okay.
Have you been there?
Who's paying?
You are.
Again? I'm paying again.
Yeah.
A buddy of mine said it was like doing the Macarena. All the kids are like, I got no money here.
That's awesome.
Oh, still paying.
The Grzelcyk connection to the Bruins extends to yet another member of the family. Older brother John Jr. also works at the Garden, making sure the ice stays smooth on game days.
Anything bad here?
As it happens, the very same ice his brother has been skating on for years.
We used to bring you over to the practices all the time, Matt.
Favorite time that I can remember is probably just seeing Jeremy Roenick in the hallway. He was doing jump rope, right? And he took a break for a second to come.
Yeah, come over and talk to me. When I first started, you know, the Bruins are the big bad Bruins, and
right.
You know, Bobby.
Oh, I mean, Esposito. Big bad Bruins. I mean, you got enough play for the other game.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm tough now.
Every time I've seen a couple of guys in chats, what's your kid a goon now?
Yeah.
Starting to trouble.
Gotta get my rep up.
Hey, come here.
Thanks.
You ready to go? Let's go.
Today we're taking our little girl, Fenway, to grab a Christmas gift. She's 3.5 years old. Melanie and I just like to take her every year to the Polka Dog, which is a store in the North End, and pick her out a toy. She's gonna drop a deuce at some point, so.
This is Tory Krug's 6th season as a Boston Bruin, and by now he's become one of the team's most reliable defensemen.
She's walking me.
Comfortable in a city he and his wife Melanie, both from the Midwest, now call home.
She's not gonna wanna leave.
Whoa, she's nuts right now.
You like this one?
No, guess not. She's not having it right now.
She's too much in the bones. We'll get you a bone too. How about that?
Thank you guys. Thank you very much.
Come on, babe. Let's go. Hey, we gotta go home.
Merry Christmas, Fenway.
It's just about 1,000 miles from Boston to Chicago, and far more than that from the Windy City to Germany, as it was for Dominic Cahoon of the Chicago Blackhawks.
When I was 17, my goal was to get drafted to the NHL, and I didn't get drafted. They were saying like that I'm too small, so I went back home, back to Germany, and played 4 years for Red Bull Munich, and yeah, it was a really good time there. We had a lot of success. My goal was to come here and make the team, and just play as many games as I can, and it's still a dream come true for me, and I just enjoy it. Gustafsson in front of us, fast driver.
The Blackhawks and the Predators get together in the United Center tonight. Not a lot of good news the other night. Not only do you lose a game, but you lose a very important piece to your puzzle when Corey Crawford gets hurt. Now, if there's good news from that, maybe it's the fact that last time Cam Ward was thrust into the number one role, he really did well. Meanwhile, some pretty good news on the injury front. They are happy to have back promising young D-man Gustav Forsling.
Forsling's a guy that can skate, can move the puck, skate him out of trouble.
For the Hawks, the game tonight against the Nashville Predators affords Cam Ward an early chance to measure himself against Pekka Rinne, last season's Vezina Trophy winner.
Well, This opponent tonight, a really good team. We've known that for a while, but they've taken 7 of the last 8 points, the Nashville Predators, and they are really solid.
Go, 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 go.
Team, they go.
Roll loose, then a steal back by side. Walks in, shoots, and Vinay got a piece.
Oh, leave it.
The press on the counterattack. Here they're going to get a chance to be on the right to the goal. Poke check by Ward, and he's able to cover it up.
It's a war there, boys. Hey, it's a war there. Don't let him to the net.
Salamaki ran over Keith, and here's a shot, and saved by Ward. Rebound. Ward makes another stop. Kane lifts it to the yellow team with a steal. Big save by Rene. Seabrook, here it comes. Save, Rene, rebound. Deflected just wide.
Come on, boys, let's bear down. The game's on the line right here.
And as the defenders, Fiala scores. Kevin Fiala snapped a shot right by the right side of Cam Ward, and in the last minute of the first, the Predators have the lead.
Hey, boys. A lot of good stuff that period. Played hard. Puck didn't go in for us. That's life, right? Bear down, move that puck ahead, and one shift at a time, boys. Let's go. Come on now.
Lots of hockey left here, Red. Artemi, why? It's our period here.
Recently, falling behind has meant near-certain defeat for Chicago. Tonight, however, the Blackhawks' hard work eventually pays off, thanks to their returning defenseman.
Pass comes back to him. He shoots it. He's
yes! Too strong tonight.
Blackhawks have tied it late in the second.
Just a few minutes later, Chicago gets another chance. And when the Hawks' defense again takes the offensive, the lead soon follows.
Find a way. Find a way.
In the third period, both goaltenders go to extraordinary lengths to keep the puck out of their respective nets. As the clock winds down, Chicago certainly knows what's coming next. One final Nashville onslaught that Cam Ward steadfastly turns aside for 3 solid minutes.
By Cam Ward!
Nice play. What a job there. Let's go, let's go.
Cam Ward keeps his team in front.
Keep it away from the goalie, boys, eh? Keep it away from the goalie.
Here's a pass in front, deflected behind Johansson. Hawks get it. Hawks clear it. Hawks win it. Cam Ward makes 30 saves in the game. Close to double-digit highlight film saves.
Hey, we played hard, real competitive, great response overall, and nice to see you guys get rewarded, Wardo. Attaboy. Let's find that level of battle again, and then we can win some hockey games. That's it.
All right, guys. Good job. That was fun to watch. Slinger, nice goal. Gus, nice goal. But Wardo.
I saw you guys respond, boys. You know, you guys worked hard, and you were deserving tonight. So, big win. Let's keep her going.
For players who can't get home for the holidays, this can be a difficult time of year. So today, David Pastrnak of the Bruins is happy to welcome his mother Marcella and friend Martin, who've both flown in from the Czech Republic.
So we are over at my house. My mom came visit from Czech Republic for Christmas. Even though we are still in America, have those Czech Christmas, you know, and the Czech atmospheres. Obviously, it's nice to have my mom around and then get some Czech food.
Mothers rarely come empty-handed, and this trip is no exception. A taste of home, of which Pastrnak has fond memories.
This is one of my favorite food growing up. Yeah, I always said I don't eat a lot of cakes. This one I always happy to have. It's good. I haven't had it for a while. Always nice service when I have mom around. Don't have to do anything. Just to sleep and go to work, come back. Everything is taken care of.
He got his tongue hanging.
Oh!
He fetches, but he never brings it back.
And he
anytime we're walking, people tend to dodge him because he barks so much and he sounds scary.
He's a protector.
Yeah, he is.
The neighborhood watch.
American-born Brandon Saad of the Chicago Blackhawks is of Syrian descent, a unique distinction among NHL players. But the story of how he met his wife, Alyssa, is as apple pie as it can get.
We met in sixth grade in middle school.
It was English class?
Yeah, I don't know. Kind of picked on her, I think, a little bit.
He would throw things at me in English class, and I would get mad. And so actually at our wedding, my dad told the story where my teacher called him and said, Mr. Wozniak, we need to talk to you about something. Your daughter has to be moved away from Brandon Saad in English class. Is that OK? And he's like, oh, gosh, what's going on? But it was something little, just young love.
This is Saad's second tour of duty with the Blackhawks. His first resulted in two Stanley Cups, with a group he finds noticeably different than this one.
When I came in as a young guy, we only had a few young guys on the team, and you had a lot of veterans that kind of led the way and showed you how to do it. So now it's a different game where I think the majority of our team are younger guys. So it's a little bit of a different feeling. They're all talented, we can all play. It's just, it really hasn't clicked for us yet.
This a couple years ago where we do the ugly Christmas sweater thing for games. Actually, I think last year was the first year we did it. We did ugly Christmas suit. This is not a suit, it's a shirt like it yelled at, but it is what it is. It's fun and we have a good time with it.
Goaltender's playing very well, so we got to get traffic on him. It's that simple. He's seeing the puck well right now, so make sure you get traffic on him. All right, other than that, you know, we're back home. We got to reestablish that here. We've gotten away from a bit lately. On time start, let them adjust to us. There's their start. We got Kretsch, Pasta, Marsh, Charlie, and Grizz, and Yarwin Nets here. Let's go in the first period. Ah! Ah!
Bruins are going to squeeze in three games between now and the mandatory Christmas break. They would love to go into the break with some serious momentum. The game is on. Anaheim has found a way to win on the road, keeping the score down.
Tonight, the Bruins take the ice, hoping to gain an early advantage. But the Boston attack is stymied, both by a stingy Ducks defense and the Bruins' own missed opportunities.
Here we go, pressure, pressure, pressure.
Pasternak looking in front for Marchand. He's got a couple of swipes at it.
Come on, hey, reach and teach, baby.
The puck comes loose to Backes. He whips the backhand back to Krug, tried the slap pass.
Come on, let's go, man. Everybody here, manage the puck. It's not good enough right now. Way too soft offensively.
Corrali with a lot of space. He closes. Can't get off the shot.
It's another scoring chance down the drain.
Well, the first period got interesting. I think the tempo's going to go upward from here.
Everyone had a little bit more to give there, huh? Yeah. A little bit more connectedness. I think that ozone, we got more time than we think if we talk to each other. Yeah. Otherwise, we're just throwing pucks to them, breaking it out for them.
0-0 through one. Anaheim playing a really strong road game, keeping the Bruins a little bit frustrated.
Play with the puck here, work together.
As the game remains scoreless early in the second period, Boston's frustrations begin to boil over.
Don't be a hero. Don't be a hero.
Until a couple of power play opportunities ultimately give the Bees a much needed spark.
Yep. Marchand rotates back. Backus tries to tap it back to him. Keeps the puck alive. Pastrnak scores! Marchand shaking his hand and getting a call for a slash.
You want me to stay high, just full zone? Yep, yep.
Pastrnak to Marchand. Cross ice, Krug scores! Tick, tack, goal!
Power play, a difference maker here so far.
It's been quite some time since the Bruins have beaten Anaheim. 9 games, in fact. But early in the third, Boston adds some insurance with a milestone goal that ensures the win.
Cranky drives it home. Yes. His 600th point. They have put things in place to zoom into a happy holiday. Yeah!
I don't normally encourage you guys to go out after a game, but you guys look sharp in your outfits. I hope you're going to parade around downtown Boston for a little while anyway, fellas. We'll see you tomorrow morning. Good win, fellas.
DB, congrats on 300 assists. This one's going to Kretch, 700 points for 600 assists.
This was good last 2 games, boys. Let's keep it going.
Yeah! There's nothing quite like winning, especially with the holiday spirit in the air. A sentiment matched by both teams, each playing some of their best hockey at the most festive time of the year. The Christmas break now offers the same thing to both the Bruins and the Blackhawks. A chance to put a wrap on the game and enjoy some family time. Knowing all the while that this season, they alone will celebrate with the ultimate party on New Year's Day. Outdoors at Notre Dame Stadium, affording them with a unique opportunity to stay focused on the imminent horizon and to keep moving forward in the best way possible. Don't forget to tune in to the 2019 Bridgestone NHL Winter Classic, January 1st, when the Chicago Blackhawks face off against the Boston Bruins.